My Sunsynk inverter is 25 meters away from my home's grid supply entry point. Despite exceeding the maximum recommended distance for using the city clamp by 10 meters, I'm still using it. Why do I do this and why should you care? Because knowing if you need to use an alternative to the city clamp can be a key information point in your decision making. Let's get some context. Hybrid inverters need to know what is going on at your home's grid supply entry point to perform key features such as zero export and active energy flow management. Some manufacturers achieve this by using an external meter, others by using a city clamp, and Sunsynk inverters can use either of these ways. City stands for current transformer. This clamp wraps around the grid supply to your home. The transformer induces electric current and sends that as an analog signal to the inverter. The induced current's intensity and direction reflect the electricity flow between your home and the grid. Thus, the inverter knows whether it should produce AC or use the DC from the panels to charge the batteries. It also uses this information if you want to achieve zero export. So why is there a limitation on the distance? As the current travels through the conduit, an error accumulates. The greater the distance, the larger the error. Thus, by the time the signal reaches the inverter, the error would have distorted it. Why is a distorted signal a problem? The main issue is failing to achieve zero export. In some cases, this could be a regulatory problem. Another issue from failing to zero export is an unwanted drain of your batteries to the grid. You see, if the inverter isn't aware that the energy is draining out, it will keep producing AC until the export grows large enough to be noticed. So how did I solve the problem? When I built my system, I wanted to achieve zero export for both of the reasons I mentioned earlier. I decided to use a network cable to extend the city clamp leads. I opted for Category 8 network cable. This may be a bit of an overkill, but the price difference was not significant. Category 8 offers better noise screening and physical strength, and this was important because the cable is running through a busy loft space with other wires that can be sources of noise. The next step, core of the solution, was to adjust a small trickle feed in the Sunsynk inverter configuration. The trickle feed is a set value of watts that the inverter will always attempt to pull from the grid, and subtract that from its calculation when matching demand in the home. It is an essential setting for homeowners with specific electric meters, such as some prepaid meters. In my case, I settled on a trickle feed of 200 watts. It took me several attempts to find an optimal value. I used my smart meter's in-home display for feedback. I kept adjusting the trickle feed and then monitoring the in-home display to notice, am I exporting or importing a small amount of watts? And how did my adjustment change the default? After a few iterations, I got it to a point where normally I would be importing 10 or 20 watts, and sometimes I would be just at zero. This was good enough for me at the time. Currently, I don't have this problem anymore because I registered my system for export. So anything I export, even the smallest bit, gets registered and I get paid for it. So I no longer have a regulatory pressure to achieve zero export. I have used this setting for over a year now, and it has been working well for me. In the months where the system produces enough electricity, I can see satisfactory results with limited import.